Yvonne Coker from the CLC Transition Team, and I'm here with my cat today. Well, not my cat, really. I sort of stole him from my daughters. But I'm here with a cat today because I wanted to make sure you knew what we were here to talk about today. We're here to talk about a cat. We're here to talk about a very specific cat, and that is the church assessment tool that we took together as a survey several weeks ago. The data has been reviewed and analyzed by our consultant, Jim Pence, and he has shared the findings with the transition team through video and through Zoom meeting. The data is good. The data is really, really good. First of all, the number of congregants who participated this year was 168. You offered up your time to answer questions and to offer comments, and we thank you for that sincerely. We want you to know that there is a power in that right there. There's a power in knowing that we have large numbers of people who care deeply about the future of this congregation and are willing to lend a helping hand. With those numbers, we can ensure that we have a broad range of perspectives and many helpful comments. Furthermore, when piecing through this information to come to terms with where we're at right now, we can see that our congregation agrees on many things. One thing that we agree on is that a very high number of survey respondents agreed that, quote, the worship services at our church are exceptional in both quality and spiritual content. We love to be here. That's what the data says. I love to be here. You love to be here, don't you? And our consultant showed us a page of performance dashboards, most likened to a series of speedometers in your car. And let me tell you, the needles are all pointing in the right direction. The numbers are good. This car is running well. Not just that, but it was running pretty well in 2014 when we last took the same survey as a congregation, and the numbers have only gotten better. And they've gotten better in one important notable category, adaptability. How do we know this? Because we each answered a handful of questions about adaptability that showed us that right now, in 2020, we believe in the strength of our congregation to adapt, and we have great faith in our brothers and sisters of this congregation that we are willing to change as we need to and able to put in the work. Change is inevitable. Change will happen. Change has already happened in that Pastor Joe is no longer a leader here in this congregation, but it is easier to move forward together if we feel adaptable. So what is the takeaway today? We as a transition team wanted to assure you that we have not pushed the pause button on this transition. You may not have heard from us in a while, but I promise you, we have been moving along in new ways from afar. We are finishing up this discernment phase, this wonderful time to listen, which culminated in this survey. We are grateful for the many comments that have come out of this process. Next, we will work to create a ministry site profile for the synod, basically a document to pinpoint where we've come from and who we are as a church. Who is CLC in 2020? And then we can recommend staffing configurations that will create the best team to move to where we want to be. Our church is not broken. We love who we are. We are strong together in wanting to make great even greater. Let's find out what's next. Have a wonderful Sunday.